There are two different C profiles used in the system. UC*FU is functional profile, to install the system kits. UC*BB is busbar profile, to install the main busbar, recognizable by the round holes to clip in the supports. The supports are installed in a defined distance, based upon the short circuit strength. There are different types of busbar supports. Three types for 10 mm copper. For 1, 2, or 3 bars per phase. Also a type for 5 mm copper, single or double bars per phase, which also works for the three types of aluminum rails. Finally, there's a flat carrier to be used for vertical busbars. The busbar support is not symmetrical, you can easily identify the directions from the side. With two brackets in different orientation, 5 mm steps can be made. With two brackets in same orientation, 10 mm steps. With 5 mm step, copper bars can be connected by overlapping, without additional connection pieces. 70 mm is the lowest phase distance that is tested in the system. Other possible distances are 100 mm, 125 mm, or 200 mm. There are visual aids on the pieces. Here the marker is set on the first hole. Four groups to the right equals 100 mm. Aluminium busbars have the benefits of much lower weight and easier wiring. Joint and derivation pieces are available from stock. The corner pieces to fix the UC*BB rails are slightly different, resembling the rail. To install the carrier, measure the codified distance. Screw in flush to the edge. And place the rail. If the holes on the lower side are blocked, the holes on the side may also be used. To install the busbar, use only design verified supports. Each set contains two types of threaded rods. The short ones are for the copper bars less than or equal to 80 mm and aluminium profiles 800 and 1250A. The long ones for the copper 80 mm and bigger, also for aluminium profiles 1600A. Follow the markings of the predecessor for quick measurement. This also helps with getting the orientation right. Set the busbar into place. And then the pre-mounted lower carrier. Using the same method for distances as before. Add the threaded rods, pre-mounted with a nut and washer. Use one screw per support put into the holes next to the supports. Fix the upper side with a washer and a nut as well. Fixed with a force of 4 Newton meters. You can also pre-mount the whole carrier system. Leave enough headroom for easy setup. The side compartment can be used to transfer the main busbar from top to bottom and vice versa, as well as for the derivation to a smaller cross section. First, install the bottom support surfaces on the frame, to hold the weight of the bars. Use the position next to the outer side of the frame, to install the lower support. Pre-mount the supports at the correct distance. Put rail in, and check if the phase distance is correct. Same position for aluminium profiles. Use connection accessory, 5/10 mm more for copper bars, to make the connection in the top by overlapping without connection pieces. Bottom support must be placed at a maximum distance as in the leaflet. The first and last supports have a specified position, the other support need to be distributed evenly in between, respecting the maximum distance. And install the corner pieces in the middle row. Put in the bar and tighten the screws. Put the supports in at the same distance as the others. For the upper rail the distance is 20 centimeters. Always put in the supports at the correct phase distance. Finally, you can put the aluminium rods into place, as well as the pre-mounted outer carrier rails, at exactly the same height as the inner ones. Insert the threaded rods directly next to the supports. This time, the shorter rods. Make sure to tighten all threaded rods with 4 Newton meters torque. With the hammerhead screws, position of the connections on the aluminium busbar is freely selectable. Before tightening the nuts, it's important that every screw has been turned full 90 degrees. Check all indication slots. Slide in the plate. Check if the screws are still oriented vertically. For wiring of several circuits less than or equal to 630A, we recommend to use a sub-distribution busbar with pre-perforated copper. For this we need the carriers UC826. Copper as needed. And multiple functional rails. The system can be installed horizontally or vertically, behind the devices kits or in the cable compartment. Use the busbar as a reference for measurements. From the middle of the first hole 40, 45, and 85 centimeters in this case. See the catalog for all configurations, depending on short circuit resistance and copper length. Mark it on the frame. Place the edge piece bottom edge flush to the marking. The carrier can be easily pre-mounted. Take care that the corners for safety screen holders are located in the outer edges. It's important that the screws are at the bottom. Determine the right distance for the other busbar supports easily, by looking for the square holes. They always have a distance of 10 centimeters. For the fixation of the safety screen, first add the accessory part on the holder before clipping it on the part. And place them correctly, they must be on the inside. Fix the bars on the carrier. Refer to the manual for correct distances. Finally, put in the touch protection. Don't forget the sticker.